Yeah, here's an example of how to save a lot of weight and money and build time. If this part was solid, I don't know how much it is, how long a build it is, sparse, but looks like it was built standing up, so I would maybe say 50 hours. If this was solid, it would easily be a 150-hour build. Here I have a sample of our different kinds of sparse fills. This would be our low-density sparse fill. It'd be basically used to keep your part weight down and your part price down. It's structurally strong as building it solid, but it'll offer you different densities. These are both high-density sparse, and you can tell because there's no layer gap. It's a checkerboard pattern for each layer instead of going diagonal one layer and then delting 45 degrees for the next layer. If you look at this one right here, you can notice that there's only one angle going one direction, and then the layer under it goes the other direction. It does a reverse delta. This is a special application sparse fill in which we use our original sparse fill group just for a middle section. This is a three-part STL file. We use our original sparse for one part, and then as you can see, this whole surface is a special sparse group in which we take layer upon layer and we mess with the raster and contour groups to achieve a porous surface in which water can be sucked through to draw a paper pulp material to make a mold.